Welcome, my name is Mrs. Clark and I am Director of Progress for the Sixth Form. Through this short video, I'm going to share some revision techniques to help your child prepare for their final exams and the assessments in year 13. I'm also going to share some top tips for you as parents to help you assist your child in preparing for those exams. There are lots of different ways students can revise. And we're going to look at different techniques and the techniques that are most effective. Mass practice and block practice are known as cramming, and students tend to do this just prior to an exam, but it actually has the least impact. Rereading and highlighting are often strategies that students use, thinking that they're revising effectively. However, again, they've proven to have the least amount of impact because students aren't really being able to take in the content, and unless they can recall it by memory, they're not really learning it. So if we look at the other end, distributed practice and retrieval practice, these are really effective strategies. It's about spreading the revision over time, and it's about being able to recall information by memory. So if we look at this curve of forgetting, you can see the blue line is the content that has been taught. And as the weeks go on, they are forgetting that content. So it's about 10% after a month's time. Whereas if you look at the pink line, you can see that if they keep going back on the information, then they're more likely to remember more. They're more likely to be able to remember 80% or above compared to 10 to 20% if they weren't to go back over the information. So retrieval practice is about being able to recall something with no notes and with no textbooks. They can do this by free recall, just writing everything that they can remember and then checking with the notes. And they could do this by testing themselves online, quizzes, Quizlet, or by using flashcards where they're creating revision questions with answers, but they're able to recall those answers before checking on the flashcards rather than simply reading them. Testing is really key. We're doing assessments throughout year 13, but students will be tested in their lessons. Teachers are doing a lot of work at the moment, really thinking about going back on prior material at the start of lessons and for homeworks and for independent zones. But students can really help by testing themselves regularly. It's about writing revision questions as they learn new content, writing revision questions with answers that they can then go back on over time to use to prepare their revision. Completing online quizzes, as I've mentioned, it's really important that they don't confuse familiarity with actually knowing material. So you might recognize something or you might recognize someone. Being able to actually recall information, their name or information about that person, can be harder. And it means really thinking back in the long-term memory. So that's the difference between recognition and recall. And it's really key when students are revising that they're aware of those differences. Creativity can be really key when revising. Creativity is intelligence, having fun. So students can summarize their notes in different ways. They might use tables and charts. They might use mind maps. Cornell note-taking. This is when, after a lesson has been taught, they try and summarise the information so it fits on one page. So it might be they've got a summary and bullet points, some key questions with some key answers at the bottom, and maybe some key vocabulary. And it's about collecting these Cornell notes so that as they go back, they can go back to that page and see if they can recall that material over time. Revision clocks is a really good way of planning how to revise for an hour. So you get a circle to make it look like a clock. You divide it into 12 sections. In each section, the students can put a subheading for that topic. And then for 5 minutes, timing themselves for 5 minutes, they need to try and write as much as they can about that information, and then go back on their notes at the end to see how they've done. It's a really good way of encouraging students to revise for an hour by dividing their time up so they can really focus. They're doing lots of these strategies in lessons, and they'll be going through them at different points of year 13 it's really important that they find a strategy that works best for them. So I mentioned that students do like to cram. They do like to study for a long time just before the exam, thinking that they're making good progress. However, research has shown, and we know as teachers, that little and often really is key. It's far more effective to build up your flashcards over time and keep going over them, even if it's 10 to 15 minutes every day, is far more effective than 7 hours the day before your exam. It really doesn't work. Research has also shown the longer you study in one go, the more you are likely to forget. So you as parents being able to stress how important little and often is really is good support. So spaced learning is about putting that into practice. So it's about taking the revision notes or the flashcards and thinking about going back on them 3 days, a week later, a month later, 6 months. And you as parents can help them plan their time by looking back at their topics, looking at when they last studied it and seeing, well, perhaps we should go back on that one and see if you can still recall it. So it's about revising topics at different intervals. It's revisiting previous learning. And by doing this strategy, knowledge will be embedded into the long-term memory. Planning revision time really is key, and again, is another way that you can help as parents. Students get study periods, and this year, because of the way things are at the moment, they are allowed to go home and work from home if they want to, if they prefer to do that. It is important that they try and plan their time. They will have homework to complete, but in order to get the best results and in order to do this retrieval and this spaced learning, they need to be adding revision into their study time. It's about focusing on that previous content. If they say to you they've got nothing to do, you can correct them. You can say to them, well, let's go back on some previous topics. It's about organising time carefully for all their subjects. Students sometimes fall into the trap of just concentrating on one subject at a time or one topic at a time. Your memory is working harder if you're able to mix things up more, and it will have more chance of staying in that long-term memory. Being organised really will reduce the feeling of being unnecessarily stressed. Students will struggle at times this year, but being organised, helping them plan their time will really help them in the long run. It's important that students look after themselves, and I know that you know this as parents. They need plenty of sleep, so it's encouraging them to go to bed not too late, not to be working all the way through the night. It's about drinking lots of water, eating healthily, lots of exercise. This is good for the mind and helps to reduce stress. Most importantly, it's about talking. Talking to your child, encouraging them to talk to us or to their subject teachers if they're struggling. But we're also here for you. So if you are concerned that your child perhaps isn't doing as much learning as they should or as much revision as they should, do talk to us. Equally, if you are worried that they're perhaps doing too much, again, please do talk to us. We're here to communicate with each other. We all want to support your child and give them the best opportunity possible. So through year 13, they will have 2 assessment points, one coming up October the 5th, week commencing October 5th, and then another one in March. They've also got their mock exams in January. For the assessment points, these will take place after school, 3:30 to 4:30. It's really important that students do attend. If you know as parents in advance for good reason why they can't attend that assessment, can I please ask that you contact me rather than the child? It's really important where possible we have all students doing the assessment at the same time, really to make sure that they're aware of how the exam process happens. They may have in the summer some exams quite close to each other, so they need to be prepared by trying to stick to these times. They will be expected to be available all week, and this includes students doing BTECs. If they're behind on their work, they will be asked to stay behind and to catch up. Assessment points will focus on prior topics, The first one will probably feature topics that they did during lockdown, or certainly in year 12. And as we go further along, they'll be mixed up a little bit more. They will, particularly for the first assessment point, they will be told what topics they need to study. And this is, there'll be more than one topic, but this is to really focus their revision. So we want them to do well so that they can celebrate their success and feel positive about it. So it is important that they thoroughly prepare so that they can enjoy that success. As parents then, how can you really help? Ask to see what they're doing, ask to see their revision notes and test them. Testing really is the best way to support them. So if they've done some revision questions, if they've done some flashcards, use them together to help test them over time. Organise a quiet study space for them. Encourage them, and I know this will be difficult, but encourage them to turn off their phones. Research has again shown that listening to music when they study isn't effective. I'm a music teacher, I love music, but I struggle to work and listen to the music at the same time. And that's because our memory really struggles to process the information from the music and from the content. Sometimes they like to use their phones to do quizzes or to use material. I like to use my phone by setting an alarm. And I feel if I've got an alarm set for an hour and a half, it really focuses what I'm doing so that I know that I can concentrate, focus, and really work until that alarm goes off. Be there as parents and contact us. So if you are concerned at all, please do not hesitate to contact us so that we can help the students achieve the very best that they can possibly achieve. We want them to do well, we want them to be successful, and we wish them all the best in their final year at Woodkirk. Thank you very much.